Today is the 30th of November, and it's the day both our smart meters are replaced to hopefully resolve our phantom drawer issue. Did it work though? Hi, John here. If this is your first time here and you're wondering what I'm going on about with the phantom drawer issue and why we need our smart meters replaced, then feel free to check out the playlist up here, which covers the issues in more detail. Bringing you quickly up to speed, our current SMETS2 smart meter, which is a Landis+Gyr E470 100mm model, in some installations can be incompatible with a Tesla Powerwall too. This results in a phantom draw or drain to stroke from the grid. We have found variants of around 2 kilowatt hours per day being recorded as usage by our electric meter when we are running on battery. Fast forward 18 months from the point I raised the issue, Tesla, Landis+Gyr and our energy supplier Octopus Energy have replicated the problem, confirmed of its existence, and found out what the reason is. There's actually a link down below from a post by Octopus Energy that explains it in a lot more detail and much better than I could ever do. So if that's piqued your interest, have a look down in the description down below for that. Octopus Energy's solution is to exchange the smart meters for customers with a Tesla Powerwall who have the LNG E470 100mm smart meter installed. As I mentioned, not all installations are affected, just a few. I understand it's about 360 people in terms of Octopus Energy's customers. There's a dedicated team of engineers that have been working solidly just on this particular problem, working round and swapping meters out for the past couple of weeks. Rich, who was our engineer and swapped our meter, he was saying, this is basically all he'd been doing for the last few weeks. And he was actually finished on Thursday of this week, which would be the 3rd of December. And he said he's been all over the country. He's been to Wales, Aberdeen, Ipswich and so on. So, he's travelled some miles. And he obviously now knows the job backwards in terms of what to expect, which I was really thankful for. So today is my day to say goodbye to my old smart meters and say hello to our new ones. Rich, the engineer, was very helpful and very speedy. He arrived from another job, which was actually just 2 minutes around the corner, having phoned to say that he was on his way. So that's obviously someone very close to me, has the same setup with Tesla Powerwall and the same smart meter, or the new one now, as it were. Rich, the engineer, got to work straight away and replaced both meters in around 20 minutes. He was actually very, very quick to do the physical swap over. I ran through my shutdown routine, which sort of isn't as complicated as shutting down a nuclear power station. However, I like to have a list of the sequence of steps to follow. And armed with my piece of paper, I shut down the power wall, the PV panels, and turn off all the electricity and power down all of my energy products as well. We were without electricity for about, without power, gas and electricity for about 20 minutes while Rich swapped out the gas and electric meters. And then once he'd completed, I then reversed my shutdown procedure and everything bounced back into life. It does actually take a good 5 minutes for everything to come back online, the Tesla Powerwall, the solar PVs, and for everything to show up in all of the apps. Previously, I'd been rather nervous about shutting everything down, just in case not everything came back online again. However, I got to thinking it's really very similar to having a computer backup. If you don't actually test that the backup for your computer can be successfully restored, then the backup is a bit of an unknown quantity and technically it could be worthless. So it may or may not work when you try to reinstall it from the backup. So the same principle with my solar, myenergi and the Tesla Powerwall components. You know, if you've never turned them off and back on again, you don't know that they'll all come back on again online without any hiccups. So it's well worth testing that out. I'll put down in the description below what my steps, sequence of steps are for shutting off and powering back on again, just in case anybody is interested. After turning everything back on, Rich did a few checks on the electrics and then did a purge and relight on the gas. We've got a gas fire, which we never actually use, but still needs to be purged and relit, make sure it was okay. And he checked the boiler to make sure it was up to pressure. Actually, the longest part of the job for Rich was to sync the new in-house display and link everything up to Octopus Energy. And when he left, the electricity had synced to the in-house display and was showing usage data, but the gas didn't want to play ball. So that currently isn't showing on the in-house display. We've got gas, just not registered. So I'm not really that worried about it, to be honest, from a gas perspective. And I'm expecting the gas to sync up in the next few days. And Rich was saying if it doesn't, then just give Octopus Energy a call because they are aware there's a note on the account to do it. The blurb that comes through from Octopus Energy, they sent an email to say that it can actually take up to 14 days for the readings to get through to Octopus Energy by the time it's all linked up and online. And you can actually check that by logging into your online account to see if there's a reading history that is showing. Since the meter's swapped, I have spent quite some time staring at the in-house display. And I get rather excited now seeing like it's showing 0 watts, 0 watt import from the grid, or worst case sort of 50 watts when we're running on battery. Yesterday was a very sunny day, and it's the first day I was able to check the in-house display was actually working. We had a full battery which had filled up overnight. Solar panels were generating. According to the Tesla Powerwall app, that we were not importing anything from the grid. And thankfully, that's exactly what the in-house display was saying as well. So hurrah, that's all good news. For the first time in 18 months, the in-house display actually agrees with the Tesla Powerwall app. Previously, the in-house display would show a constant draw of 200 to 300 watts of grid draw all the time, whether we were on battery or not, but generally when we were on battery. It was like a base load, if you like. The only thing I have since noticed is that the in-house display doesn't appear to show grid export. A Twitter and YouTube friend, Nigel, from EV Puzzle Channel, he sent me a screenshot of his in-house display, and I noticed on that he was showing export. And his make and model of in-house display is exactly the same as mine, so I'm not sure why mine isn't showing it. I know he's got a different smart meter than me, but even so, I would have expected it to show export, as my old one did anyway. So, yeah, not too sure about that. I'll have to monitor that. So that's the only thing I don't currently understand and need to learn a bit more about, why that is. And the reason to wanting to be able to see the export is I have the in-house display with me in the office next to where I'm working. And I'll regularly notice when we're exporting or if we're exporting. And if we are, then I go and check to make sure that the eddy has actually heated our hot water. And then if the car is plugged in, that is actually charging. So we don't want to be exporting without, you know, utilising that excess energy. If I've utilised it, well, then, you know, fine. Begrudgingly, I'll export it. But, you know, if I'm not using it, like the car's not plugged in, then I shall rush around and plug it in. So that's why I like to know when we're exporting. At the moment, the only way I can do that is through the Tesla Powerwall app until I can understand why the in-house display isn't exporting. But yeah, there you go. Final piece of the jigsaw puzzle, I guess, will be a confirmation from Octopus Energy on the credit to my account. And I'll let you know as soon as I know what that figure is. Please do like, comment, share if you've not already done so and hopefully subscribe too. Your interaction really helps my videos and helps my channel to grow and gets seen by more people as a result, as YouTube recommends it to other people. So for those that do get involved and comment and share and like, thank you very much. It means a lot. And that's it. Thanks for watching. I'll see you on the next video. All right, take care. Bye.